Hello, everyone, and welcome to Fabric Tech Talk TV. I'm your host, Patrick LeBlanc, and today we have the King of RTI with us, Brian. Brian, before we get started, why don't you tell the people who you are and what you do?
Sure. Hi, I'm Brian. I'm from Denmark. I'm a part of the community. I try to help people understand the way of fabric, the way fabric works.
The way of fabric. All right.
And especially, I try to help people understand the suite of real-time intelligence inside Microsoft Fabric.
All right, fabric. This is the way. Okay. All right. Okay. So, I am a data practitioner.
Yeah.
I've been doing data for decades. And, you know, I hear about real time, but I think about the way we used to process and move data. We use DTS packages.
Yeah, exactly. From SQL Server 2000, maybe.
We use SQL Server Integration Services.
Yes.
We use Azure Data Factory. And now today we use pipelines and data flows inside of Fabric.
Yeah, exactly.
But you're telling me that there's another way.
Exactly.
All right.
So historically, yes, we're used to use pipelines and perhaps a lakehouse nowadays inside Fabric, and then a semantic model.
Yep.
And then we end up in Power BI, standardized reporting, you know.
Sure. Yeah, but the best reporting.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's the center of the universe.
Power BI is the center of the universe. So, yeah. But the issue with that approach is it might not fit every business case.
Sure.
Because sometimes you have data that you need insights to within a second or within a millisecond or two.
Yep.
And with this approach, then you will have notebooks running all the time, you will have pipelines going nuts, and you will have a lakehouse with really tiny transactions all the time inside the Delta Parquet file. And we both know that doesn't work.
It doesn't work.
So, yeah. So that's why we have real-time intelligence inside Microsoft Fabric, because this service or this suite of services helps the business to get a very, very an extreme short time to insights.
Okay.
From when the event happens to it's available for the end user
to consume.
Yeah. It could be around milliseconds or something.
So instead of that nightly batch processing or that every twice a day batch processing,
you're
talking about narrowing that latency down
24 hours
down to minutes,
milliseconds.
Wow.
So
wow.
A business use case here could be perhaps you are the Azure administrator.
Yeah.
And you have a lot of virtual machines inside Azure.
Sure.
Those virtual machines, their CPU consumption, if that goes haywire and beats the 95% limit, then you want to know now. You don't want to know when the data warehouse has refreshed tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
You want to know now and you want to react to it.
Got it.
That's where real-time intelligence comes to play. Not only in the Azure infrastructure, but also if you have IoT devices, if you have a conveyor belt, if you have vehicles running around the streets to deliver packages or pick up things, or just when an event happens and that has significant business impact for you to need it now, that's real-time intelligence.
So instead of being a reactive
shop,
I'm waiting a day, I'm waiting an hour, then I can go analyze it to see what's happening. I can be more proactive.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And the architecture behind real-time intelligence is also very simplified. On the slide now, we have all the IoT devices on your left-hand side.
Yep.
And then we pipe those events that are coming out of those into the event stream. The event stream are then picking up the messages. Inside the event stream, you could do simple transformations like grouping, sorting, filtering, those kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And you pipe them over into the event house. The event house is highly capable. It's almost, I won't say infinite, but it's close to infinity limits, because you can just hit it with whatever data you have. It will absorb it, it will save it, and it will provide it to you when you need it.
Wow.
When that's said, then normally end users say, I just want it in Power BI. Can I get it in Power BI?
Yeah, why not?
The problem with Power BI is it only refreshes when you click something.
I can set up the auto refresh.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah.
You have a limit of... if you change the...
I knew you were going to say
that. You have a limit of... I think it's 1 minute or 1 second. 1 second.
I think there's five.
5 seconds?
I think it's five. Please, don't quote me, but it's something like that, right? There is definitely some latency.
Exactly. Right. And the latency is also, you need to save it in the lakehouse or Kusto database, and then from there, you know.
Yes.
This is where real-time dashboards comes to play. Because the real-time dashboards, they live on top of the Kusto database.
And so it's as the data's coming in, the dashboard is...
It's refreshed automatically, yeah.
So we're shrinking. So if once the data hits, it goes through the process on the dashboard, right? So we're shrinking the amount of time that it takes a consumer to see what's actually happening.
Okay. And we are also changing the way it is utilized, because normally we get people to analyze historical data, what's happened.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This mindset is we are going to set up mathematical calculations and then tell you, now we encounter an error. This is what you need to do. Do something.
Okay.
And we no longer have to sit and look at the real-time intelligence dashboard. We can just set up an activator, get a notification on Teams or email, start a Power Automate flow.
Yeah.
And if you want to, you could actually just call a second API and then perhaps get a text message saying, hey, your server is utilized 96%. Do something.
Wow. That's different. That's much, much different. Yeah. But so I get it. I get it, right? So we got real time. It's, you know, I'm proactive. But what about historical analysis? What if I want to? What if I need to persist my data and do historical analysis?
That's no problem.
Okay.
I think this is perhaps the easiest way to persist data and make it available to the rest of the Fabric suite.
Okay.
Because inside every Kusto database, you have just a ticker or a switcher and then
toggle.
Yeah. Toggle. And then that data, all the data from that database is then piped out to one lake in Delta Parquet files. And then you're good to go.
It's the one drive for data.
Exactly. Right?
And then I can have access to it. And if I want to do some analysis, if I want to write Python, if I want to do other different languages on top of that data, I can do whatever I want. If I want to put it into a model and write some DAX and do my own calculations, I can
just
go ahead. Easy.
Is it? I don't know.
Yeah, it's a piece of cake.
Perhaps I'm more into the Kusto query language.
Okay, all right, KQL.
But that said, we don't need the data in the event house. Reference data like master data or product lists or something, those can still reside on a lake house or in one lake. Then you can shortcut those into the event house and then you can use it.
Right, that's right. Yeah. So like reference data, possibly. Okay. So data that's not really streaming. Maybe it's a list of products. Maybe it's a list of locations or trucks or something
vehicles,
like that.
Vehicles.
I don't need to have that persisted. I can have that in my lake houses, my warehouses, wherever.
Exactly.
A shortcut from that.
Exactly.
Okay. Right. It's very efficient.
Yeah.
Right.
So with this new approach,
we
now have the question to the business: how much of an emergency is this data for your business? Is it critical in a short time?
Yeah.
Or can you wait for it until, you know, like an hour or tomorrow or minutes?
Yeah. So that's the only challenge, right? It's getting that question answered. Besides that, the data is right here at my fingertips.
Yeah, exactly.
In milliseconds.
Within milliseconds. So if we compare those two solutions, those two setups, eventually that will happen. So at the top here, we have the traditional way.
Yeah,
with pipelines and lake house and semantic models and Power BI reports. Yep. And in the bottom, we have
Patrick's way.
And in the bottom, we have, you know, the real-time intelligence.
Yes.
This is not a fixed number, but I just say, hey, typically we see minutes at the top.
Yep.
And then at the bottom, we see milliseconds. Yep. Need it now, use real-time intelligence. That's the way to do it.
But I'm curious, though, like, even if I don't need it now, it seems like the infrastructure with RTI and the process to get it from source to destination to consumption, so it's somewhat similar.
It's very, very simple because you have it in one service in the event stream.
Yeah.
And the event stream can listen to whatever data you have.
Yeah.
And the connectivity built into Microsoft Fabric for the event stream is just, it's amazing how many connectors we have standardized. And if you don't have a standard connector, you can always expose the underlying API endpoint for the event grid or event hub. And then that will be handled by the event stream.
Wow. It's amazing.
So, yeah, exactly.
That's it.
I have one. There we go.
All right. So I'll be honest with you. So I've built out in the past probably 6 months, I've built out a couple of warehouses and a couple of lake houses. No, not one single event house. This has got me thinking, all right, my next project, the next thing I'm going to do is take that warehouse and convert it over to this.
Oh, no.
Hear me out, because I need the data quickly.
Yeah.
I need the data. The data's coming in from an API, and I need to It is streaming data, okay. Right? It's data from my YouTube channel.
Okay, got
so
it.
I want to capture those metrics as frequently as I can. And so I can do some analysis and be a little more proactive on like how many views.
That's
I
a good idea.
Hour.
Perhaps fun. Get a push message when you get a notification or a comment.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. You're reading my mind, right? And so that's what I'm going to do. All right. Thank you so much, Brian, for joining us here on Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to post them in the comments below. If this is your first time, I'm here. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. And as always, from Brian and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you next Friday. Thank you, everyone, for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget, hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you'd like to see on future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric.